May the Titans, our Asian marauder ants, rest in peace. And hopefully as well to the dragon spirit and the conclusion to this curse. AC family, we have finally come to the end of this epic ant story, in order that we may start a new one. AC family, welcome to Eldragon Island. Please subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon. Welcome to the AC family. Enjoy. Here we stand, AC family, like celestial creators at the genesis of our newly created and uninhabited island known as Eldragon. A massive dragon skull adorned one of the island's rock shelves, placed there to commemorate and appease the dragon, whose spirit led to the ultimate demise of the Garden of Eden, which once lay where this island now stands. Let's hope this monument and us naming the island after him are enough to ensure the dragon's curse doesn't carry on to these new lands. The island itself is very dragon-like. Eldragon's waters are pure, fast-flowing, and awaiting to be given its fertile sands to be the bed from which new life awakens. Soon, these waters will be teeming with life. I am super excited today because for the very first time on this channel, we will be creating a Paludarium, a part land, part water vivarium containing various originating creatures, which will all be interdependent on each other, including our brand new Polyrhachis ant colony, which you saw from our video 2 weeks ago. And AC family, I have some really exciting news about these new ants of ours. After consulting with friend and ant taxonomist David General from the University of the Philippines, Los Baños, I was finally able to get a complete species ID and profile on these gorgeous ants. Turns out, these ants are the species Polyrhachis seminermis. What was super cool was that, like most Polyrhachis, their feeding ecology is currently unknown to biologists. They are greatly unstudied, and he suggested we create a setup that would maximize chances for observation of behavior. And AC family, we had the perfect home for exactly that. With this new island here, we were going to get a god's eye peek into a world of ants like no other human has before. Now, are you ready for the coolest revelation on these ants? Dave informed me that these Polyrhachis happen to be weaver ants. Yes, they are a species of ant that use the silk webbing capabilities of their larvae like glue to build nests within the leaves of plants and similar environments. Eldragon Island, therefore, with its lush tropical plant life and sticks, was the perfect home for these ants. So the time has come. Let's stock this island with life. First, we needed to make this Paludarium viable by working from the ground up, the lowest ground point that is. The waters required a bed of substrate in order to sustain its needed life forms. I had some newly washed aquarium sand for this, so I went in and gave Eldragon Island's turbulent waters some earth. Like a thick cloud of soot, the waters carried and blew the black sands around the entire Paludarium. Now, I designed this Paludarium to be an island surrounded by a moving river. I personally hate having still water in a setup, not only because it festers much more quickly, but it also creates an ideal location for mosquitoes to lay eggs. So a submergible filter installed at the back helped create that awesome water current. I also wanted Eldragon Island to be protected from any creatures from the outside coming in, just in case those wild, unwelcome feral ants, or crazy ants, decide to make a comeback and deem this island their newest conquest. History does tend to repeat itself. Moving waters meant a much more difficult crossing for outside intruders. Now, about this water, I had to ensure it was biologically ready to sustain creatures. You see, we can't just use ordinary tap water and expect life to thrive in it. If we did, aquatic animals added would die, not only due to the tap water's chlorine, but also due to the lack of necessary microorganisms which help keep any aquatic community healthy. So a couple weeks ago, I had to take aquarium water from my other larger biologically established aquarium. This ensured El Dragon's starting waters contained some pioneering beneficial bacteria needed to properly sustain life. So I had to wait a couple weeks to build up these beneficial bacterial colonies before I could ever consider adding anything inside it. This is what aquarium enthusiasts refer to as tank cycling. Alright, but now that El Dragon's waters had its microorganisms, it was ready to house our first set of inhabitants. Let's meet our new aquatic creatures, shall we? Now, I decided that since the main inhabitants of El Dragon were endemic to Asia, I wanted this Paludarium to be an Asian biotope, basically incorporating species of plants and animals that were also native to Asia. Here is our first species. Presenting Java moss, belonging to the Hypnaceae family of mosses. It is native to Southeast Asia and grows well in aquariums. It attaches to rocks, roots, and driftwood quite well, and also offers a great home for aquatic microorganisms and creatures. But you will soon see what I intend for its biological role to be in the river of El Dragon. Next, I would like you to meet our newest friends, shrimp. These here are Caridina multidentata, a mano shrimp, native to Japan and Taiwan. These shrimp feed on soft algae and decaying plant matter. They will help keep the waters of El Dragon clean and free of most algae. Next, we have these beautiful shrimp, known as cherry shrimp, Neocaridina davidi, from Taiwan. These shrimp are omnivorous and will also feed on various microorganisms, decaying organic matter, and algae. They're all quite cute, aren't they? Finally, I have some interesting color forms of these cherry shrimp, including two golden-back yellow shrimp and an orange and blue shrimp. This multicolored colony of shrimp will be amazing first additions to our aquatic portion of this Paludarium and make great inhabitants to El Dragon's river. Hey, AC family, what should we call this river surrounding El Dragon? And what should we name this new colony of shrimp? Leave your name suggestions for both in the comments for us to vote on in a future video. Now let's have a look at El Dragon's river world after our Java moss, shrimp, and other additions were installed. Wow! AC family, take a look at that! I've also added some Java fern and hair grass, native to Southeast Asia, as well as some gravel. A carbon dioxide diffuser was also installed to support our plant life. Now look at how cool this entire system works, AC family. So we have an area of fast current here, like the main river channel. Then the river goes from turbulent to a more steady stream here at this slot. The shrimp love hanging out in this area. Around the corner, we come to clumps of Java moss, which are amazing because they act as natural filters, sifting debris and dirt carried by our river current through this area. The dirt actually nourishes the moss, and our shrimp are there to pick at anything organic. The water continues forth into a pool where our filter blows it around again in a continual cycle around El Dragon Island. Isn't that just amazing? In no time, El Dragon's river went from slightly cloudy to crystal clear. It will soon be established enough to house other aquatic creatures. But for now, let's move up on land. El Dragon Island was designed to be an Asian biotope, but it is not a true Asian biotope because it harbors a few plants from South America, namely these telangias, Spanish moss, and this moonlight caladium. I chose these for humidity, size, and suitability as a home to our Polyrhachis ants. Here, I have some Asian pothos. These plants grow out of three small aquariums full of dirt, which make up El Dragon Island. My hope is that our ants move into these plants. Let's cross our fingers, AC family. Let's get to it. The moment we've all been waiting for. It was time to set our Polyrhachis ants free onto El Dragon and see how they like this brand new island home we made for them. Ah, I am so excited. Here we go, placing the test tube inside and removing the cotton blocker. Let's watch. ants immediately began to explore. Look at how excited they are! They climbed the plants and driftwood and explored curiously around Eldragon Island. And look, it seemed our island was definitely working at keeping the ants contained. This was so awesome! And now it was time to give our new Eldragon inhabitants a housewarming gift. I placed drops of honey at two spots on the driftwood, and in no time, the ants came around to drink. And wow! This was my first time to have a real good look at them, unobstructed. These ants were absolutely stunning! Look at them! OMG, look at this! Even the queen came out to feed on the tasty honey drop. Wow! This queen wasn't like most queens who sit around in protective cover, waiting for her workers to bring her food. No, she was hands-on with her army. Risking her life out in the open, she was brave enough to feed with her pack. Isn't this just incredible? And that's not all, AC family. Check this out. I placed a crushed cockroach leg onto one of the plant leaves. And look! A worker came around to eat it, but suddenly puked something out before diving into the cockroach leg. What on earth was this dark drop she puked up? Could she have emptied out the contents of her social stomach so she could fill it up with this fresher meat? Or was this some kind of solid waste pellet, like those regurgitated by owls? Whoa! Like a hungry lioness tearing meat off a carcass? I could literally see the ant tearing the cockroach flesh off the leg piece and eating it. What we were witnessing here was the feeding ecology that my taxonomist friend David was talking about that was formerly unknown to biologists. Can you believe that here was something biologists haven't had the opportunity to observe or study much? And AC family, together we are the first to witness the beauty of these Polyrhachis ants feeding in this manner. What an awe-inspiring moment and sight. All this nourishment will be stored inside their social stomachs to be brought back to the brood and grow their colony. And just when I thought things couldn't get better, literally 5 hours after moving in, I checked the test tube and the ants were nowhere to be seen. My heart jumped into my throat. Where did they go? My eyes scanned Eldragon and deep into a little pocket of leaf foliage, I saw them. They had carried all brood into this pocket of leaves. AC family, our Polyrhachis ants had elected this spot a suitable location to build their new home. This was just magical. It was so amazing to be able to witness Eldragon sustaining life. I even spotted a snail that must have come with the soil and was able to swim across. I've spent several nights watching the river currents bringing debris to nourish our mosses and little bits of matter for our eager shrimp to pick at and eat. One night, I managed to catch the shrimp eating the leftover cockroach parts of our ants. The ants must have casted it into the water when they were done feeding from it. And well, it seems, one ant's garbage is another shrimp's treasure. It was apparent that all life forms on Eldragon Island were living cooperatively in perfect harmony and interdependence. It was all just so beautiful to behold. Eldragon Island was well on the way to blossoming into an awesome community. Until I saw it. Something crawling on the glass that filled me with great concern. Oh no! Wild Pharaoh ant scouts were checking out this new island of ours. It didn't seem they could get across, just yet. This is not good. We can't have what happened to our titans and our jawbreakers happen to our new Polyrhachis ants. It was only a matter of time before these scouts will go back to their main colony and let them all know of our lush island. The time has come, AC family, for the release of some special guardians. We needed to add a colony of beasts into the waters of Eldragon to protect our island inhabitants. And I knew the perfect creatures for the job. Oh boy, AC family, Eldragon Island has been off to a great start, but we must make sure we protect it at this early stage so these wild feral ants don't kill our Polyrhachis ants. Tune in next week to see what special guardians I add to these waters. And AC family, I know you will love them. You won't want to miss next week's episode, so do remember to subscribe if you haven't yet and join the AC family and hit that like button every time, even now. By the way, AC family, give yourselves a huge pat on the back. Thanks to you, last week's video trended at number 2 in the US. That's a record for us. I feel we're like a powerful, growing, and unstoppable ant colony, just conquering the YouTube space. Thank you so much for the support, guys, and showing the world how awesome ants are. It's inspiring to know that people really appreciate nature. AC and our colony, I have left a hidden cookie for you here if you would just like to watch some extended play footage of our new Polyrhachis ants eating to the sounds of some relaxing music. The footage is actually valuable to biologists researching this largely unstudied ant species. More about that next week. AC family, I also wanted to plug my new daily vlogging channel. And yes, that's daily vlogs. For those wondering what I work on in between these weekly ant videos. Thanks to all AC family who have already subscribed. Alright, and now it's time for the AC question of the week. Last week, we asked, name any of the creatures we found while digging into the Garden of Eden. Congratulations to Sam Ras, who correctly answered, earthworms. We also accepted springtails, snails, and black crazy ants. Congratulations, Sam, you just won a free ebook handbook from our shop. In this week's AC question of the week, we ask, what did we observe in these Polyrhachis ants that was previously largely unknown to biologists? Leave your answer in the comment section, and you could also win a free ebook handbook from our shop. Hope you can subscribe to the channel as we upload every Saturday at 8 a.m. Eastern Standard Time. Please remember to like, comment, share, and subscribe if you enjoyed this video to help us keep making more. It's ant love forever.